What's up, YouTube? It's your boy Fax, and today is a very special day for us. As you know, it is Breast Cancer Awareness Month, and I'm here with this very beautiful woman. We kind of probably look alike. That's because it's my mother. My mom was actually diagnosed with breast cancer several years ago, and I just wanted to let her just talk to you guys about her experience, because it really is just an encouraging experience.
You know, I used to work at a bank,
right?
And it was time to get a mammogram, and I went to the doctor and had it done, and he said everything was fine. And then about 3 months later, I started having pains, and they were sharp pains, and they would hit me every once in a while.
Mm-hmm.
And I paid no attention to it. I kept on working. And so it kept on, and then finally, I called the doctor, and he said, well, you just had a mammogram, you're fine, you know, and so kept on. And then about 6 months later, I was going across to the drive-up window, and a pain hit me so hard that it stopped me in my tracks.
Wow.
And the girl said, you better call your doctor, there's something wrong. So I called him. He said, well, you know, you just had a mammogram, you're fine, but if you feel better, come on in.
Right.
So I went in, had another one. And in about 2 days, he called me and said, I'm sorry, you need to come in. Went in, and of course I was shook up because I knew something was wrong.
Right.
And I did have breast cancer stage 3, and I had it,
so,
but they missed it.
So not to cut you off, but for me, when you say breast cancer stage 3, can you kind of tell me, like, what is that, like, bad, or
it's pretty bad, stage 4.
Okay.
And it's
it's almost terminal.
Yeah, it's terminal.
So you, again, I had very minimal knowledge of this, and this was almost 20 years ago, right. So 1996, which, you know, I guess I was 11 years old, 12 years old. So
I didn't want anybody to treat me any different.
Right.
And but I was depressed. I told my husband, so he knew about it. And what I told some people, I told people at the church, and there was a lady at church that had just had breast cancer, and she had gone down to St. Louis, so she gave me the name of the doctor.
Right.
And it was a lady surgeon. And I got in touch with her, and she got everything.
I was gonna say, how long was the process of finding out? So I can imagine it was pretty quickly. I mean,
she did. She went, well, as soon as I found out. I mean, of course, I'm a nervous wreck. I got cancer, and so when I talked to the lady at church that had it, she got me in touch. She gave me the number to this surgeon. I called her. They were so quick. They called me back the same day.
Wow.
And they gave me an appointment within 2 days to come and see her. And after I seen her, then she gave, within that week, I was having surgery.
Wow.
And
no playing around.
No playing around, because it was that serious.
Right.
Because it had gone that far from the time that, you know, that I had. So, and she got it all. And people say, you know, I'm a survivor. I don't think I'm a survivor. God is the survivor. God is my survivor.
Right.
I don't believe that I did anything. God did it. And whenever I needed him. And that was a reminder to let me know that he was
always
with me.
At the cross. Wow.
He was with me whenever I was in trouble.
Well, I just remember you just claiming healing, and it wasn't like it was a question. Like, we never questioned that anything was going to be bad as far as, like, you're going to pass away or anything. Like, we just knew.
Yeah.
You know, and you've always been that example of a strong woman, a strong individual. And I think that just helped me to witness that, and I think everybody around, the family as well, just to see how you just took it in stride. you know, and you know, it's just encouraging, you know, and that's why I wanted to tell, to show our Kicknology family that, you know, even though things are happening, trials and tribulations do always, you know, it's always going to happen, but the main thing that we need to do is to trust God and follow the cross, you know, and that's
right.
I just really wanted to talk to you and, you know, I want you to have the last word, just to kind of maybe what scriptures you were going through,
okay,
or what, maybe something like that, just to leave the family with, and
okay,
to just give them some encouragement.
I did have, while I was going through this, before I actually had the surgery, I had some church members, one church member sent me out a tape that I would listen to every morning, praise songs, and I would listen to it, not every morning, I'd listen to it all day long. And then
wow,
praise songs. And then I would go down in the basement,
mm-hmm,
by myself, and she also gave me scriptures,
right,
to say. And I would say those over, uh-huh, and over again. I am healed by your stripes.
Wow.
By your stripes I'm healed.
Mm-hmm.
And different scriptures like that, you know. I plead the blood of Jesus over my body.
Mm-hmm.
I would say those over and over.
Right.
I'd go down that basement and by myself,
yeah,
I would say those,
mm-hmm,
you know, talk to God.
Wow.
And I believe that's what brought me through.
Got you through it, yeah.
Yeah. But believing and just, you know, in just believing that God was going to heal me, you know.
Yeah, wow. So, I mean,
yeah,
I don't really have anything else to say about
that
other than that. I mean,
yeah,
if, wow, it's just speechless.
Yeah.
Really, just because just to hear, again, you know, just the strength that you have, and, you know, we definitely, we love you, and we're glad that you're here to be the woman that you are, continue. So, with that being said, we're going to get on out of here, talk to your mom, sit down and interview with your mom if you had to or whatever, just to get those kind of moments in, because this is the first time for me to really sit down and reflect. So you guys are seeing it first, and it almost broke down, but she almost had me break down, but I didn't. So but yeah, man, we're out of here. We'll have the information for the breast cancer awareness shirts that we will be donating to a great cause, and I know breast cancer has touched someone in some way, shape or form, so that's why it was really important to me to sit down with my mom and let you guys see what's helped me become the man that I am today as well. So we're out of here, and we'll see you next time. We're gone.
You taught me everything you've given me. I always keep it inside. You're the driving force in my life. There isn't anything or anyone that I could be, and it just wouldn't feel right if I didn't have you by my side. Oh, you were there for me to love and care for me when skies were gray. Whenever I was down, you were always there to comfort me. And no one else can be what you have been to me. You will always be. You will always be the girl in my life for all time. Mama.